Now let's go and see how the tracheostomy will be inserted.
There is two methods of insertion of the tracheostomy. You can have patient have tracheostomy inserted by surgical incision. The tracheostomy will be inserted by ENT, usually a doctor, in the operating theater. That one by direct visualization of the trachea. Another method, which is maybe common in the intensive care units, the percutaneous dilatation tracheostomy. This will be done at bedside.
As you can see, the kits are similar, even different, like let's say company or manufacturers, but at the end they are all doing the same like benefit, the same job. How they will insert percutaneous? Let's imagine this is the trachea, okay? And here is the endotracheal tube because our patient is intubated. What they will do, they will push the endotracheal tube up a little bit so they can insert the needle first, okay? And here to see this needle, they will insert bronchoscopy here tube. So they will observe the needle insertion. After they insert the needle in the trachea, then they will insert guide wire. After the guide wire, they will dilate. Then they will use this big dilator, which will be similar to the shape of tracheostomy. They will dilate. After that, they will put the tracheostomy, they will inflate it. Then if they make sure that the tracheostomy has connected, they will connect it to the mechanical ventilator or ambu bag. Then they will take this ETT out.
The team will put a bronchoscopy through the endotracheal tube. They will take the endotracheal tube up, maybe level 16 for the adult or 17, so they can see and observe the insertion site of the trachea by the camera. By the needle, they will go on the second or third tracheal ring. And after that, they will insert guide wire, dilator. Then they will put the tracheostomy tube. Now for the nurses, what's the important? The important is to make sure that your patient has the consent, his MBO 6 to 8 hours, the labs are okay, the BT, BTT, hemoglobin, and we prepare the equipment for the insertion, the medication needed, the sedation, local anesthesia. A bronchoscopy machine usually will be handled by the respiratory therapist, and we need to make sure both the procedure that there is no complication like bleeding, pneumothorax, subcutaneous emphysema.